Hello, my friends of Atari Labs. My name is Saul Montoya. Welcome to this tutorial. This tutorial will be a long tutorial, and I hope that you can follow up through the whole, through this whole modeling process. Okay, what are we going to do? We are going to develop a model of a coastal aquifer in Modflow with ModelMuse. Okay, this tutorial will have two parts. I mean, the first part will be the GIS part, that we are going to do a research on the model features with QGIS, okay, and the second part will be just the Modflow model, okay. So this tutorial is going to be for about half an hour, okay. And okay, so great. We hope that you enjoy. You will receive on the description of this video. You will receive this, sorry that this computer is kind of low today. Okay, you will receive this modeling coastal aquifer in Modflow with ModelMuse and QGIS, because it's a well used QGIS. Okay, great. So you will receive this. And then we are going to open this in QGIS 3. So here is on the browser. This is okay. And we have two raster files. First is the background image. So I just double click here. And as you say, it has applied the WGS. That means that these are geographical coordinates, but those are not geographical coordinates. So we have to. We have to, sorry, right click here, and then apply 3271 name. Okay, right. So once again, you just, I don't know what disappears in my other window. Let me decrease this. Okay. Still appears in my other. Okay, great. So it appears a window that you don't see because it's in my other window, and it says set layer CRS. So and then it appears this one. So it's 32718. So it's UTM WGS 18 South. Okay, great. Okay, so disappears because it, and then right click, and then appears another that you say soon too late. Okay. I'm sorry about that. I don't know how to. So this is the background image. Okay, it's already. I mean, the project is in geographical coordinates. You can change it to. To. 3, 2. Okay, so okay, it's already. Okay, so what else? Well, that we are going to add is the domain. Okay, this is the coastal aquifer. Then we have the sea. This is the sea. Then we have some observation points. Those are the observation points. And then here on the open attribute table, that is a window that you don't see, it appears this one. Okay, great. And actually, you can do these as well. These ones as well, open the attribute table. Yeah, so you have easting, northing, terrain, screen elevation, and that is. And observe value. Wait. And one of these is the observe value. We are going to sort that out. Okay. Okay. Okay, so this is the observed value. Okay, great. What else we have here? We have the recharge, because actually recharge is only on, recharge on the system is not on the whole domain, but it's only on certain it's only on certain fields. Okay? Okay. Yeah. Okay, and then we have the river. This is the river. And then we have some wells. Those are the wells. And this is the active zone. Okay, great. So let's start our numerical model. So I'm going to decrease this. And then I open model. Okay. In ModelMuse, we are going to open a new mod for project. Okay. You can declare this. It's actually not. It's only. Okay. It's only declarative because it do not have any influence. In this case, we are going to simulate one layer, just one layer, that will be alluvial aquifer. Okay. Oh, sorry. Again. Sorry. ModelMuse. Okay. New mod flow model. 3271A. Okay. And this is only one. But here is a alluvial aquifer. Yeah. But this is the no grid option. That's the important thing. No grid option. Okay? Okay, so here we are in the no grid option. Okay, great. Before you have, maybe I can do a project. Again, in a window that you don't see, it appears safe. Or maybe this one. Save project. And it appears a window say where you want to save the project. And then I want to save the project on the folder. And then you will have as well the here I will create you will have this project as well. Well, it will be referenced to my computer, but you can reference to your computer. And it will be project one. Okay, great. You have to close all the files here, because somehow, if you are working with local files, locked, yeah, and then you cannot import in ModelMuse. So you have to close all your QoS files that you are going to use in ModelMuse. Now you have to close all check files that you are going to use in ModelMuse from QoS. Otherwise, you cannot open in ModelMuse. Okay? So we have saved the project and then we close, because actually we close QoS because we want to free the software from. We want to free the shape file from the lock that model that QAS applies to those shape files. Okay, so I go here to file, I go here to import, and then I go here to shape file, and I will import the my documents in modeling. On shapefile, I go to domain. To domain. This is the domain. Okay, This is one shape. Set value of enclosed cells. Nothing else. And nothing happened. Okay, why? Because we are going to select through this one. We're going to select this domain. Okay, I change color, why not? And then I will use this to set the grid cell size. Okay, in order to set the grid cell size, this is really an issue because at least you want to have more than 20, from 20 to 50 is the minimum of rows and columns. Otherwise, your model will be so coarse. Okay. So in this case, if you the lowest, I mean, if you apply the lowest dimension, yeah, divided by 20, yeah, it will be. So here it apply 200. It really depends. I mean, if you are if you have a higher discretization, you actually will have a bigger model, and then it will run on longer time steps. And then if you have a small discretization, then you have a coarse model, and it will run faster, but you will have a low resolution. Okay, so that's it. Okay, and nothing happens because actually we have to generate it. Okay, with this one we generated it. Okay, and it will, since the aquifer is actually kind of inclined, I mean the axis is inclined, so we will let model news to understand to calculate the grid angle automatically. Okay, great. So that's awesome because actually in very small amount of time, you have inserted a grid on the side. Okay, what else do we need? We need to import two images. We want to import the select image from raster, the background image. And actually, it comes with a small referencation file that makes it automatically georeference. Okay, so it's painless. Okay, great. So we have the pattern. Okay, what else do we need? Well, what we need is to specify the aquifer thickness. And in order to specify the aquifer thickness, we are going to say that the aquifer thickness of this is 200 meters. So here in the data, in the data set, the definition, model top that we are going to apply, but the aquifer thickness will be related to model top minus 200. Okay, apply and close. Yeah. Okay, great. Now we have to import the topography. We are going to import the topography file, import surface grid file, and we are going to import the topography from the raster file, then, and then we have a GRD that is a grid file that has the topography. Okay, and in our case, we are going to apply that directly to our model. So we are going to apply to model top and set values by interpolation. In this case, we can set intersected cells, but actually, it is if you go through model news, there are more options that you can do this. If you change your resolution, well, it has a deeper discussion of how do you insert the topography, okay? But for this case, I think that you are beginners with model with Moldflow with Molmuse. And we are going to just apply set value intercept cells, okay? Point close to cell center, and that's it. Okay, great. So here we have. Okay. I made a mistake. Because there is a part of the dem that actually do not have, if you see, there is a small part of the cell that actually do not have a, there is a small part here of the cell that do not have elevation value from the raster. It can happen. Okay? So look what I'm going to do. I'm going to apply control set. And it will undo. It's the same as doing this. Undo, okay, and then I will import again, import surface rig file, okay, but this time it will be on model top, but it will be of interpolation, point close to center, okay, yeah, and look which will be the difference, okay, so this is point model top, but this is by interpolation, and it will apply, okay, nothing happens, because you haven't applied any interpolation methods. So you go to data, you go to data set, you go to required, you go to model top, and then here you apply a interpolation method that will be fitted to. Okay, so this is okay. Okay, great. So now you have the raster. Okay, and then the vertical acceleration is too much, so I will apply as 5 of vertical acceleration. Okay, you have the advantage, my friends. You have the advantage that you have the in the video. You have the pause and play. So actually, I'm not going to repeat all the steps because you can do pause and rewind. Okay. Okay. Again, otherwise this video will take 1 hour and a half. Okay. What else I'm going to do? I'm going to select this. Okay. To select this, it doesn't appear here. It will be on this one. This one will be. I will apply it to. That will be from model top to allure aquifer bottom, and it will be active and it will be true, and this part will be true. So this is the actual part. This is the active part of the active part of the aquifer. Yeah, but the rest will be inactive. So I go here to data sets require hydrology active false. And so what does it mean? That by default is false, and just the part that is inside the aquifer is true, is active. So if you see with this, here you have the active part. Okay? Now it's active part. Okay, great. What else do we need? We need some other features, and let's go by on required. I need the KX will be 1.5 e to the minus 5. Okay, and then on model we are going to apply the models that we. I mean flow. We are working on LPF. We have recharge. We have well. We have evapotranspiration. We have river. and we have generative boundaries. Okay, those are the recharge well, evapotranspiration, GHB, and river. Okay, great. Then on observations, I have the hops, and on solvers, I will apply this to 250, and a relaxation of 0.03. Okay, that's it. Okay, great. Okay, but I will import now the C file, import shape file, and then here shape file, C, this is a value of enclose, this is only one shape, the C will be applied in one at zero coordinate, why not? And it will be a GHB that it will go. Okay, direct, okay. Again. File, import, check file. See. Yeah, it says set value of enclosed and then say okay, and it will appear this one. Okay? This one will have, I mean, first I want to see grid here because it actually if I do the show all, well, actually I can, the grid will, yeah, I can use this to create the grid, so I can set that to 200, color the scene to horizontal, and it will be as well the active part to do. Okay, so then I generate the grid. Mm-hmm. And if I show the active, okay, do you see that? Is that? Okay, great. Okay, so now I have the theme. And then I will apply this okay, here is my data set. It is active and as well is a GHB that goes from minus 1 to 0 because I'm working on steady state 0 and then direct and the conductance is 0.001. Okay, great. So now I have my GHB already done. Okay, what else do I need? I need file, import, check file, and then I will the rivers. Okay, set value of intersected cells. This one will be single multiple object, and this one will be at model top. This is the elevation where the boundary condition is located. Okay, then I go to features, then I go to river, then I go, this is from, I will apply this later, so just here is what I'm going to do, so this is okay. And then if you see it's here, and then I change color, and then I strongly recommend that you put position lock, otherwise you can unwilling change the location of the river, and then you know that the river is unchanged location. Okay? color. And this is the river. River stage is equal to model top. Okay. This is direct and this is the conductance as of 0.01. And the river bottom is equal to model top minus 1, because I assume my stage of the river. I strongly recommend that you read the river passage paper, okay, on the mode flow online. Okay, great. So this is the river, and I will change the color of the water because everything is blue. Okay, great. So here I have the active part, I have the river, I have the, I will insert the recharge. So I will say data, edit data set, file, import, check file, and then I will apply the recharge. This is the recharge. It will be set value from closed cells. It will be recharge is actually at zero, but I have to change the parameters on the model output partition programs. And nothing else. I will apply. And these are the recharge. It's in single multipart, because otherwise every polygon will be separated. So this is, I will apply okay, great. And this, the recharge is at zero, and then this is the recharge, this is from minus zero to, and then I will apply a recharge value of 1 meter per second per 1 meter per year, or 1,000 millimeters, so it's 1 meter to 1 meter 2 times. This is per year, so if I divide it by the number of seconds per day and the number of days, this will be in meters per second. Okay. Okay. Great. Great. Once again, I don't like. Okay, great. Now I have the recharge, and then I need the evapotranspiration. On the evapotranspiration, what I need is, I'm very lazy, so I will apply, I will use the object that applies the domain, on the domain, the aquifer, and then I will apply the evapotranspiration to this object. Yeah, you can do this. This is recycling. Okay. This is low, less, this is less carbon footprint of your numerical model. Okay. The evapotranspiration rate will be the same, so it will be 1.5, let's say that will be 1.5 divided by 1.5. The evapotranspiration surface will be model top, and the evapotranspiration depth will be 1 meter, okay, because this is the routing depth. Okay, great. Okay, so here we have, I have to go partition programs, boundary conditions, and the recharge. I have to set these two top active cells, okay, and then I go to layer groups, and then my aquifer that is by default confined will be convertible, and they will be discretized in 3. Okay, great. What else? Okay, so I need the world. I need the world. Okay, so I will open. Save your project. Why you have to save your project? Because otherwise, model Sorry, because it's so long, so slow. Okay. So far, if you like our videos, if you like the tutorials, and then if you know, if you find that there is no more, there is unless the tutorial from Richard Wilson from the USGS, the developer of Modern Muse, there are not so many resources for online education or like documentation on video. Okay, please give a like to this video. Okay, so on the description of this, on the bottom part of this video, yes, give it a like and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Okay. One. Great. So, okay, that's great. So now what we are missing is only the hop, and then we are only missing hop and wells. Okay, so we start from the wells, import, check file. And these on the shape file, these are the wells. The value of intersected cell. Import shape file as separate object. We will apply one attribute of the well, and which is the attribute of the well? It will be the bottom screen. No. Because this is the okay. Okay, great. On data, no, on features, we have to go to well package. And it will be from minus 1 to 0, and the pumping rate will be flow in cubic meters per second. Okay? Great. And direct. Okay, that's it. And then we apply. And then, okay, those are all the wells. Oh, the colors are crappy. Let me object, file object here. I just apply the wells and then here I only select the wells. Oh, sorry. Here I select all the wells, position log, and great. Okay, great. Okay, so now I have the wells. Okay, and then what I do need to import is the shapefile, the observation points. Okay, set value of intersected cells, separate objects. One, it will be where? It will be, actually, this for the observation point, this is not related to the observation, but let's see that you are going to apply the observation points to the screen bottom elevation. Okay, great. And then here on data, no, on features, you go to here to hop, and it will be 0 because, and the observed head will be the attribute of water level, the statistic, it doesn't matter, and the observation will be the name. The name or the okay, and these will be all heads. Okay, okay, and then once again, hide all objects, then I select all of them just to change the color, because otherwise colors are important. Okay, great. So now we have almost everything. Let me check. We have partition problem, layer group, time is by default in a steady state. We have program locations. Okay, we save our project. We run our project. Sorry, because it's so long. And then it will be a num file. And I have some warnings for you, and this is the same. Oh, sorry. Okay. Some warnings are just message that the computer gives to you from certain conditions. Those are messages. I mean, doesn't mean that if you have a warning, actually you will have that the model won't work. Okay? Actually, if you are dealing with such complexity, you always have warnings, okay? Yeah. For example, it appears that there are some state conversion, some of them are inactive, and so on. Why not? Okay? Then we close this, and then we go to the bottom part, and then we say, okay, this is the most. These are the volumetric budget, okay? And here, these are the wells, actually, oh, wow, sorry. The wells are pumped, are injecting water. Here wells are injecting water because that when we imported, okay, we imported. Let me here when we imported the, for example, for one well, multiple features. This is positive. Okay. Don't worry, I will do it again just for you. Okay, thank you. Hide all objects, and then I just select the worlds. Okay, and then I select all the worlds, and then I apply delete on my keyboard, and then I have deleted all the worlds. And then I will import the thing. Import check file. Okay. Check file where, okay, here set value of intercepted cells, one that will be at bottom screen, okay, on features will be well, and starting time will be minus one. Minus one, ending time will be zero, no parameter name, and the pumping rate will be this with but with a minus. And then you change, because minus is that you are pumping, and positive values are that you are injecting. Pumping rate interpretation defect. Okay. Now let's check object tile object. Here I just put the well. And then if I select one well. Well, there are wells with zero pumping rate. Oops, sorry. I have done something wrong. Let me check. Okay. Something has happened. Okay, I will delete. I will object, hide all objects. I will show just my wells. And then I will delete this because I have to import it again. Okay, file. Let me check file. Oh, I will open the QS, okay? Here. On the QS project. Sorry, I have to open QS3 because actually launches QS2. Okay, so far let's give an introduction about ourselves because it can take a minute for us to upload the QS. I'm sorry, I'm working on a not very high powerful computer. We are Qatari Labs. What is Qatari Labs? Qatari Labs is a blog dedicated to the knowledge sharing in water resources. We have a lot of tutorials of QIS, Python and Modflow, and some tutorials in open form. You are invited to follow us in Facebook, in Twitter, and in a newsletter that we have, where we send tutorials at the maximum of three tutorials per week. I mean, it really depends how much, how many posts do we have. What is the purpose of our blog is to provide you useful information. So actually we are not funded by any research funds. We are just doing this because we like, and we have courses that you can take, and if you take our courses that are in our website, you will give us a strong support to further research and further tutorials. Okay, our tutorials are completely free of charge, while the courses are of course paid, and it is our main intention to give you value. I mean, we know that software is great, and then you can do lots of things with software, but if you don't know how to work with it, if you don't know how to use it, common topics of aquifers or exploitation, so really sustainable solution for the future problems and the current problems will rely on software. So what we like is that there are more people training on the uses of this software, and then we can achieve better results in the future. Okay? So So we have a Facebook account and a Twitter account, a newsletter, and here we have some courses that you can take. And well, that's what we are. Okay. Whoa. Okay, I will try once more. Okay, I think I will stop the transmission here, and then I will come. Oh no. Okay, here is my project one. Okay, and these are the wells. If I see the open attribute table, it appears this one, and the problem is on the sign, yeah? And the sign is, I will open the attribute table, and then here, I will create a minus, a mode flow queue on meter square per second. Mode queue. And this will be here in records will be minus. Minus Q. Okay, that will be okay. Okay. I will delete what I have done because I have set up as create not cubic meters per second, and it won't be a integer, it will be a real, and it will be a minus minus Q. Okay. Again. Okay. Well, Okay. Once again. I will delete this. Okay. And I will insert QMod. Yeah. And it will be a real, and it will be precision 5. Minus. Okay, that's okay. I save it. I save my project and then I close it. Okay, and then file, import, check file. Closure de explotación, set value of intersected, separate objects, one, bottom screen, data, features, well, minus one, zero, pumping rate, it will be Qmod. Because that this one's negative and it will be there. Okay. Export, import this. Okay. And now, if you see, let's say object, file object, I will change color. And this will be, well, then okay, and that's it. How do I see this? Because I do on data visualization, like here it was on none. But if I go here to pumping rate, okay. Okay, now I can go to back to okay. I run the project. Okay, I will replace it. There are warnings. Okay, and then, okay, conversion was great. Then I go here to the, and say, okay, the river is, or like, give 38 liters per second, because I do the conversion, this is cubic meters per second, 38 to the sea. The sea actually give 0 point less than 1 liter per second to the system, and the recharge give us 280 liters per second to the system, while the wells pump 294 liters per second, and the system provides, I mean the groundwater system give 24 liters to the sea. Okay, that's it. This is the water one. Okay, great. However, fine. And then I'm going to import the results. Okay, and then I have the HD. I will import this, and then as a control read. Okay. And here I see the difference, calibration is needed because as you have seen here, in head observation, you can open the hop out. And here you can see that the residual is huge. So actually you have the simulated values are really small today. And there are a lot of wells that observation wells that are those observation wells are empty or like are dry. So you need some calibration. Well, this will be a nice topic for a coming tutorial, or or further analysis. Okay, as you are learning, maybe this tutorial will be very extensive of the amount of commands in order to create a numerical model. As we have seen, this numerical model is not calibrated, okay? It's not intended to be, because we have to improve the boundary conditions. However, and then there's something that I strongly advise to you, ¿ya? If tú I strongly advise that you learn from the output as well, that you learn, that you read. Yeah, this is because I know that at this time you might be exhausted, okay? But if you want to fully understand what is going on with the model, yeah, you have to learn, or you have to read the list file. Yeah, you have to read the list file, then you have to see how the hydraulic head, how the distribution of the hydraulic head, and then if the result that you have really fits the nature, okay, or what you have seen on the observation point or on your conceptual model. Okay, so far it was really a pleasure to give you this tutorial. Thank you, and really thank you for following us to the end of the tutorial. Okay, this has been already an hour. Okay, and I have been receiving some nice emails from followers. Yeah, and okay, here my email is, I dropped my email. Okay, this is my email. Okay, if you want to discuss, if you want some, mostly about discussion, if you want to discuss something about groundwater modeling, or like the topic of coming tutorials, or whatever that you can do with Modflow or you cannot do with Modflow. No, it's my email in Spanish. Sorry. Okay, this is my email in English. Please send me an email. We warn you that we do not do homeworks, and then we don't provide special assistance about your specific model. Okay. This is more like in order to have a discussion of what will be good, or what it will be the application, or if we can provide a tutorial of something, of some specific cases, we might provide it, okay? So far, thank you for following us, thank you for following this video, and I hope that you have a great day, and hope to see you in coming tutorials. Bye-bye. Bye!